Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In this video, we are going to make a complete home automation system to control 4 appliances and a fan speed using ESP RainMaker. As you can see, I have already installed this system in my home and I am using it since last week, so the system is stable and tested. Although I have used the PCB to make the circuit compact, but you can make the complete project without using any PCB. I have shared all the details during the video, so please watch the complete video. After that, you can easily make this home automation project for your home. Now, before going to the details, let me tell you what are the features of this home automation system. As I have used ESP RainMaker, so you can also control all the appliances with Alexa and Google Assistant.
Alexa,
turn off the room light.
Okay.
Let me turn it on with Google.
Hey Google,
turn on room light. And you can also control the fan speed with voice command.
Alexa,
turn on the fan.
Okay.
Alexa,
make the fan speed 4.
Okay.
The fan speed increased. Thus, you can control the fan speed with voice command. On the PCB, I have connected the DHT11 sensor and the IR receiver. So, you can control all these appliances with the IR remote. Let me show you. So thus we can easily control all the appliances with the IR remote. Now let me turn on the fan. You can see the fan turns on, and I can also use these two buttons to increase and decrease the fan speed. Let me increase the fan speed. So thus we can control all these appliances with the IR remote, and we can also use this manual switch. Let me show you. And I can also control the fan speed with this regulator, and this is the switch for the fan. I can manually turn on and off the fan with these switches. If the ESP32 connected with the Wi-Fi, then this blue LED will turn on, and we can control all these appliances with the ESP RainMaker app, and we can also monitor the real-time temperature and the humidity reading. Now let me control the fan with the ESP RainMaker. First let me turn on the fan. You can see the fan turns on, and now let me increase the fan speed. So as you can see, the fan speed is now 3. Apart from that, we can also use Alexa to control the fan speed. So from this, we can also control the appliances. You can see the toilet light turns on, and to control the fan speed, I have to go to device and then select all device, and here you will find a fan. And from here we can monitor the current speed, and we can also control the fan speed. So we have decreased the fan speed to 1, and we can also turn off the fan from this dashboard. Now let me go to Google Home app. So here you can see from this dashboard we can also turn on and off the appliances, and we can also monitor the real-time feedback. Let me go to ESP RainMaker app, then let me turn off the toilet light. You can see the real-time feedback. Let me turn it on, and you can monitor the real-time feedback. And we have also used the preference library, so the ESP32 can remember the last GPIO steps. Let me turn off the complete supply. Currently ESP32 do not have any power supply. Now if I turn on the supply, you can see the ESP32 automatically connects with the internet, and appliances automatically turn on according to the previous states. So this is a very useful home automation project you can easily make for your home. So without any further delay, let's get started. These are the required components for this project. If you don't want to use PCB, then you can connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. I have already explained the circuit in my previous video. You can find the link in the description. But I will always recommend you to use a PCB for any electronics project, and you can easily design professional PCBs using the Altium PCB Designer software. Altium is the most trusted PCB designer software by all the big electronic companies. With Altium, you can easily search any electronics components, compare the datasheet, and it has lot of useful features which will save you a lot of time while routing any complex PCBs.
There are a lot of tutorials available on Altium, and the user interface is so simple, you can easily learn this software and use it to design PCBs for your upcoming project. I will highly recommend you to download the free trial version of the Altium PCB Designer software from the video description. For this project, I am going to use this PCB, and these are the required components for the PCB. And after soldering all the components, the PCB will be look like this. And here you can connect external Bluetooth device, LoRa module or any other microcontroller which can communicate with the ESP32 through serial communication, but here we are not going to use that features. So I have just connected the DHT11 sensor and the IR receiver, and you have to connect the 4-step fan regulator with these pins. You can refer this circuit to connect the high voltage appliances and the switches with the PCB. Please take proper safety precaution while working with the high voltage. Now we can move to the coding part of this project. These are the source codes for this project. You can download all these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article, you can find a link in the description. Then you can download all the codes from these buttons. After downloading, you can use this code to get the hex code of any IR remote buttons. I have already explained the process in my previous video. And this is the main sketch. Let me open the main sketch. For this project, I have used the ESP RainMaker. So you have to install the latest ESP32 board. For that, first update the preference URL, then install the 2.0.5 version of the ESP32 board. And these are the required libraries for this project. Then in the code, if you want, you can change the node name, and these are the device names. If you want, you can also change these names. Google and Alexa will identify the device with these names. Then you have to update the hex code of the IR remote buttons. And if you refer the same circuit, then after doing these changes, you can directly upload the code to ESP32. For that, go to tools, then select the board as ESP32 dev module. And select the RainMaker in the partition scheme, then select the proper port, then hit the upload button. I have already explained the code in my previous Blink project. You can find all the related video link in the description. If you go through the code, you can easily understand. Still, if you face any issue, you can always let me know in the comment section.
After programming the ESP32, you have to press and hold the boot button for 4 seconds. Then release the button. After that, you have to scan this QR code with the ESP RainMaker app. But before that, you have to turn on the mobile GPS and the Bluetooth. Let me turn on the mobile location and the Bluetooth. Now I will tap on add device and scan this QR code. I will share this QR code in the video description. You just have to press the boot button and scan the QR code. Now I will tap on pair. Then I have to enter the Wi-Fi details. After that, I will tap on next. Now this may take some time, and you will find all the device will be added with the ESP RainMaker app. Now I will tap on done, and you can see all the device added. Now as ESP32 is not connected with the sensor, so we cannot monitor the sensor reading, but you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicate now it is connected with the ESP RainMaker server. Now we will quickly connect the Amazon Alexa and the Google Assistant with the ESP RainMaker. For that, I will go to setting. Then I will select voice and service and select the Amazon Alexa. Then I will tap on this link with Amazon Alexa. Then I will tap on this link button. Then you have to log into your ESP RainMaker account. I will just tap on continue with Google. Then select the email ID. So we have successfully added all the device with the Alexa. Now we will connect the Google Assistant with the ESP RainMaker. So I will open the Google Home app. First, you have to create a home. So I will tap on create new home, give a name. After that, tap on continue. Then you can also enter the address. I will skip this step. Our home is created. Now I will go to setting. Then here I will tap on add device and select works with Google. Here search for ESP RainMaker. Then tap on the ESP RainMaker. Then tap on continue. So our device successfully added with the Google Home app. If I go to dashboard, and here you can see all the device added with the Google Home app, so we can also control it with the Google Assistant. Now we have to connect this PCB with all the appliances and the switches as per the circuit.
then you can easily control all the appliances with the Google Home, Amazon Alexa, and also with the ESP RainMaker app. And if there is no internet, still you can control all the appliances with the IR remote and manual switches. So this is a very useful project and you can easily make it for your home. So if you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such projects. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.